Hello students, today we are going to discuss topic binary arithmetic from chapter 1 number system and codes, subject digital techniques 22320. As the name suggests binary arithmetic, that means in this we are going to study addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of binary numbers. We have already studied binary number systems and the different terms related with the binary number systems. So binary number system is having only two numbers, that is 0 and 1. Since the total numbers in the binary system is 2, the radix or the base number is equal to 2. Along with that, we have studied the terms of the binary. If only single digit is there, then it is called as bit. If four digits are there of binary, it is called as nibble. If eight digits are there, it is called as byte. If 16 digits are there, it is called as word. And if 32 digits are there, it is called as double word. Now also along with this, now today we are going to study one different term related in a binary, and that is called as carry. You must be knowing this in the decimal number system also. So while addition, the numbers, for example 5 plus 5, you get answer 10. Now in this, the 10 answer which you are getting is called as sum. So the result is called as sum. So if you add and if you subtract the two numbers, whatever result you get, it is called as difference. So here we are going to study also one term that is called as carrier. Now carry, that I'll make you understand when we'll start with the binary addition. So we'll start with the binary addition. There are four basic rules for binary addition. It is not like your decimal addition. So here in this table, I have shown two numbers. The first number is of single digit, and that is A. And the second number is of single digit, that is B. Single digit. So single digit, because for any addition you need two numbers, and the first number is named as A and the second number is named as B. But here only single bits are there for addition. Whatever result you get, it is called as sum. So A plus B is equal to sum. Now sometimes if you remember in decimal addition in school also, if you have done, it is like 67 plus 63. When you add, so it is a two digit addition, 67 plus 63. So when you start adding, the very first thing what you do is you will take the 7 of first number and 3 of second number, that is units place, and you will add of both the numbers. So 7 plus 3 becomes 10. So in this, you write 0 down, that is in the sums place, and 1 you carry to the next bit, that is 6, next digit, that is 6 plus 6. You are going to add 6 plus 6 plus 1. So this 1 is called as carry. So in binary system also, it is called as carry. So here, the extra bit which is getting extra bit which you are getting after addition is called as carry. So that there are two inputs, A and B, and whatever answer you get, that is sum. It is actually output. So that is result is output, and there are actually two outputs now. So now in this table, if you add A if you take a as 0 and b as 0 and if you will add 0 plus 0, the answer sum you get is equal to 0, and also the output carry is not generated. So there are two outputs, sum and carry, and both are 0 here, written here. So now the next condition, if a is equal to 0, that means the binary bit a is 0 and the next binary bit which you are going to add b is 1, then when you will add 0 plus 1, you will get answer sum as 1, but carry is not generated, and therefore in the carry column it is written 0. In the next column, 1 and 0 is written. That means if binary bit A is 1 and binary bit B is 0, and when you will add 1 plus 0, A plus B, so you will get sum is equal to 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. And also there is no carry. So in the carry column it is written as 0. So the next combination, that is if binary bit A is 1 and also the next binary bit B is 1. So that means if both binary bits are 1 plus 1 and 1. So when you will add A plus B, you will get sum as 0. And one carry is generated, and that is written in the carry column. So carry, which this carry bit which is generated will go to the next binary bit, and the answer actually sum is 0. So this is the binary addition table which you are supposed to by heart. It will help you for binary addition in the next slide. So there are binary addition in your paper. It is very important. So one simple binary addition example is taken here. So we are going to add 2-bit binary here now. 1 1, this is first number. We are going to add this with the next number, that is 1 0, and we are going to apply the binary addition rules here. So you can see how it is applied. Check out this table. So 1 1 is written on above side and 1 0 down, and we are going to add this. So for the 1 1 is 2-digit binary number, I'll represent it by A. 1 0 is second number, I'll represent it by B, and we'll start addition. So very first thing, we are going to start with the LSB bit of both the numbers. So your LSB bit of A is 1 and LSB bit of B is 0. So we'll start from there. So first we are going to add the digits 1 plus 0. When you'll add 1 plus 0, you'll check the table. In that table, A is 1 and B is equal to 0. You get sum as 1. So you're going to write sum as 1 and carry is 0. So no carry is generated. So nothing, no carry. Now next bits you are going to add, that is A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1 in the next column. So when you are going to add 1 plus 1, check the binary addition table. So when it is 1 plus 1, sum is 0. So sum is 0, which is written down here, and the carry is generated. Carry is 1. So carry is going to the next binary bit. But here binary bits are not there. That means it is 0. So when it will go up that with the 0, so 0 plus 1 is 1. So we are going to write it down here. So that carry comes down here, and yahan pe it becomes your MSB bit. So the final answer is 101. I hope you have understood. You will be able to understand with this example of binary addition. Now here 4-bit numbers are taken. So first number A is 1011 and the second number B is 1010. So writing in this column, we'll start with the addition, we'll start with the LSB bit first. So from here we'll start LSB bit. So first digit is 1 year and the second digit is 0. So 1 plus 0 we are going to add. So 1 plus 0, check out the binary table. 1 plus 0 sum is 1 and no carry is generated, carry is not there. So directly sum you are going to write it down here, so that is 1. We'll go to the next consecutive bits, that is 1 and 1. So we are going to add the next number 1 plus 1. So when you will add 1 plus 1, so that becomes sum is 0, which is written down here, and carry is 1, and carry is shown above in the blue color column. Check out there. So now when we are going to add the next bits, there are actually 3 bits now. 1, 0, 0. That upper one is called as carry. It is going to the next bit. Now this carry, and when we are going to add this, so when we are going to add this, we are going to add 1 plus 0. That the first 2 bits we are going to add. So we will get 1 plus 0, result is 1. And then that in that result we are going to add next bit, that is 0. So 1 plus 0 is again 1. So and no carry is generated, the sum is 1 here. Now next bits we are going to add, that is 1 and 1. 1 and 1, you check out the table, sum is 0. So 0 is written down here and carry is generated, which will go to the next bits. Now here no next bits are there, that means there is a 0 there. And if you will add that carry, that is 1 with 0, you get the final answer as 1, and which is written down here in the MSB bit. And the final answer of this addition is 10101, as shown here. I hope you have understood the binary addition. You have to solve few more binary addition problems to understand it perfectly. It is very important, because next the binary addition comes for every other topic. So it is necessary to add binary addition.